Step one, load the instrument. The end of stitch pop right in. It loads very simply. Pull back. In this case, I have the 48-inch suture. Since I'll be doing a running stitch, give myself about 9 inches or so of suture to work with. Right there. This is really an incredible instrument. I was fortunate enough to be one of the first surgeons back in 94 when I was a fellow at Duke to get my hands on this. And ever since then, it's been a love affair. Okay. Now I'm just going to load the instrument in my trocar. And my grasping instrument. And load that as well. Okay. And we're going to do a running stitch. Okay. Now we're going to start off by taking a nice deep bite of tissue. I'm going to toggle, that means transfer the needle. Okay. And one of the key steps is pulling the suture back so you have about 1.5 to 2 inches of suture on your tail. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a surgeon's knot here in a couple throws. 1, 2. Always close the instrument when you pull back. And notice how my left hand, which is like the anchoring hand, doesn't move much at all. We call this the post. I'm going to keep that straight the whole time. It's going to be straight up to the sky, and it's going to stay that way the whole time. Now, as I come in, this is one of the key aspects, is looking at my loop. And if you'll notice right there, it forms a D, with the post being the vertical part of the D and the loop being the round part. So notice that the D forms, and the free arm of the end of stitch, without the needle, goes right through the D. From your perspective, it's a backwards D, but it doesn't matter. Then I just go behind the post, transfer the needle, transfer it back, and just pull. Okay? That's the fundamentals of the knot. Now, if the loop gets caught up here, it's not a big problem. Just bring it down. If it goes up the shaft, just pull it down, and then just tighten it. Just like that. Okay. It's 2. I like to have at least 3 or 4 throws. That was a miss right there. We call that a swing and a miss. There we go. 3. Now notice I'm watching my loop as we go. Boom. Like that. Pull through like that. Okay. Now I'm going to do the running stitch. Got the needle on each side. There's 1. You're going to push the needle all the way through. Sometimes thick tissue, if it caught up, just do it again. 2. You have to squeeze real hard in this thick tissue. There's 3. Okay. Now, there's a variety of ways to finish. I'm just going to finish by tying to a loop here. So I'm going to grab my suture about 1 centimeter from the base. I'm going to come down and pass the needle again. Okay, now I'm going to use this loop here as a post and keep that straight up and then just pass my needle around both sutures. Oh, that thing got in the way. Just use the free arm to get it out of the way. And just pull that down. Pushing with my left and pulling with the right. The post comes straight up again. Now notice the loop. I'm always looking for that loop and putting the free arm inside the loop. And a good 3 or 4 knots should do it. And that's it.